Hello everyone and welcome to Usitility. Today we are going to see how to play Mirage Perfect Skyline on PC using the brand new BlueStacks 5, that is designed for blazing fast speed and high octane action. It packs a punch with mega performance upgrades and it has faster performance than any other high-end Android device or Android platform. We will be able to easily download and install Mirage Perfect Skyline and enjoy the game on our Windows PC with keyboard, mouse and big screen thanks to BlueStacks 5, which is the Android emulator that we recommend to play Mirage Perfect Skyline. So without further ado, let's get to it. First of all mates, to get started we need to launch our main internet browser. We open the one we prefer. Let's go to that URL that I have highlighted in green color. There you are seeing it on the PC screen. You don't need to type anything, because I added a clickable link in the description of this video and the first main comment. We landed right here on the site of Usitility, in which we include an in-depth demonstration on how you can download and install Mirage Perfect Skyline on PC. We scroll down a little bit and mouse click on the Download Game on PC button. Once we click on the link, we get to the site of BlueStacks. No panic, it is only the Android emulator that we will launch to play Mirage Perfect Skyline on our PC. It is now obvious that we get a number of pros of preferring the emulator. Now we will proceed to download the Mirage Perfect Skyline by simply clicking on this button Play on BlueStacks that you can see here in green color. We then click on that button. And the download action starts and ends immediately. Voila! Here is located the download. It is an executable file. The following step is to launch the executable file, so we have to click on this file. If we are on Windows 10 it will have asked us for permission to make changes to the laptop or device. We clicked yes. I minimize the browser to view the installation software significantly better. The installer is quite simple. It includes a couple of choices, install, and setup path. I will talk about what setup path genuinely does. We just simply click on it. And we observe that we have now here the path where the emulator is going to be placed. If we plan to change for better this directory we have got to click on the browse option, and we pick another folder and install the emulator where we choose. I prefer to leave it by default. I simply click on back. And I simply click on install. Now, there it is. The installation begins and it is going to commence along with the download of all these MB which are represented on the computer screen. When you download it, it is likely to be a little more or less megabytes. The data transfer rate can be faster or slower, subject to your internet and depending on the performance of the emulator web servers. Now they are running extremely fast. The download is finished, and now it proceeds with the installation phase. With BlueStacks 5 you can even reduce RAM usage with a single click. Especially useful if you ever face performance related problems. In addition, you can activate Eco mode to enjoy 87% reduced CPU usage, 97% reduced GPU usage and easier multitasking. As you can see, BlueStacks 5 is built to provide stability and performance during long gaming sessions. The installation has already finished for me. Now, the emulator has been launched successfully. As you can see, down here, there's a progress bar which will move forward to the right then when it gets into the ending, the emulator is going to be started for the first time. In fact, the emulator was already launched, there for the first time. Before we continue, as you can observe, it made a couple of software icons there on the computer desktop. The BlueStacks and BlueStacks multi-instance. Note that the BlueStacks app icon will be the only one we are concerned with. Whenever we desire to launch Mirage Perfect Skyline on our PC, we twice mouse click on this particular icon and consequently launch the emulator. The BlueStacks multi-instance icon allows you to launch multiple emulator instances. And with BlueStacks 5's new improved multi-instance manager in Eco mode, players can run more game instances faster and with less lag. Let's perform the following step, which is actually a requirement, and which is to begin to browse the Google Play Store. And we will simply click on Play Store. As you can see the Google Play is launched. Right here we are required to log on. Now as soon as we are on this page, we must definitely conduct this next phase that is imperative. So we just click on Sign In. Now it says Checking Info. It may once in a while get blocked in Checking Info. Additionally it isn't going to continue. If so, you could try to connect to your account after a couple of hours and it will surely very likely be sorted out. Now we will insert our email address and password. The email address is required to be a Gmail email and its matching password. For example, you can utilize the same email address you're using at this time in your YouTube account. So that I will insert my data and I'll come back when I have completed it. That's it, details inserted. Find out Google welcoming us and supplying us their tools. We must agree to them all by pressing, I agree. Next, it offers us to backup to the Google Cloud. You can also let it selected it's going to generate a backup of your data on that device to Google Drive. I am not going to check it, you can make use of this option if you prefer. We mouse click on accept. Google Play is launched automatically and completely on its own. To set up the video game, we are required to get to the Android emulator desktop by simply clicking on this app icon marked green colored. Now that we are watching the desktop of this emulator for Android, we notice that we have now there the install app game button. We then click on the button. Here we get the video game. Let's just click right here on the install link that I'm just displaying now in green color. And it will begin the setup. Presently it would install the Android game, it will take quite some time or it may just be very fast. That all is dependent upon on our internet connection. This has by then finished installing. Now, let's go to the emulator desktop by hitting this particular option that I'm showing in green, that allows you to use Mirage Perfect Skyline for the first time. We are by now on the emulator desktop, and as a consequence we're preparing to simply click the fresh Mirage Perfect Skyline app icon that was created. The video game is launched for the very first time. So there we end up with it. I can also mouse click anywhere on the screen and also make use of the keyboard. I will comment on the volume level of that emulator. It's right here. We use the icon of higher volume along with the icon of lower volume. This way we do not depend on the Microsoft Windows volume to increase or decrease the audio of this emulator. And to enjoy the experience to the max, we will switch on the large monitor, for which we have two alternatives. This is the first one, we then click on this particular app icon which I am basically mentioning in green color. And the screen is maximized, coming with one border on top, one on the right side and the third one at the bottom. If we really want to have fun with the application using all the screen, we click that software icon. And we'd at present be experiencing and enjoying the Android game in 100% screen function. To stop the 100% screen functionality, press the F11 key. And we'd at present play in regular display setting. Now I am starting to demonstrate to you the computer keys mapping that is definitely rather cool. This strategy we will certainly be in a position to use the game app a lot more easily. The first task is to press this computer keyboard icon. And there you will be able to get the recommended controls. I can put the normal configuration, though if you like to adjust it, you can easily do so without any problem. As you can see, the emulator is totally in our language. On occasion it occurs that your emulator is presented in the erroneous language, as an example, in Japanese. And consequently to set it in the correct language we browse here to the cogwheel. And here inside of many other controls, we click that language drop down. We may very well go with the language we like, Italian, Chinese, and so on. Once the language is decided, we could save, the emulator would restart, as well as the game application, the next time we launch it, will also be in the chosen language. Now, there's another element that we have to take into consideration, and this is that we will get an email indicating that a completely new device has been associated with our Google account. It will certainly check with us if we are the ones who have associated with that electronic device. Indeed, we shouldn't get worried, because the emulator is simulating an Android electronic device. And to discover which electronic device is currently being emulated, we go right here, to the cogwheel and we then click on it. And we go here to the model choice. And now we observe that the emulator is behaving like a Samsung mobile. And so we're going to receive an email saying that a new Samsung device has been connected to our Google account. That's all folks, so much for that video user demo. I sincerely hope you appreciated it, specifically that everyone found it informative. If that's the case, allow it a good thumb up, subscribe to my channel, and any comments, requests or ideas, leave them in the comment box down below. You can also leave a comment on my Twitch channel, I perform live streams every now and then, you have it below in the video description and in the very first pinned comment. Just click on any of those training videos that happens to be appearing on the computer screen and see you in the upcoming training videos. Bye.